Congressman Adam Schiff joining us to talk about all this. A lot to talk about in Washington, D.C. Start, though, with the Russian collusion angle story. You've been investigating that, and now it looks like Facebook and Twitter getting some focus here.
Yes, Facebook disclosed about a week or two ago that the Russians basically had bought advertisements aimed at the American electorate. And what we ought to be shocked by about this is the fact that the ads they bought were designed to basically turn one American against another, to exploit very divisive issues. They were anti-immigrant, they were xenophobic and anti-Muslim, and they're basically trying to sow discord in the United States. It's what you'd expect of a KGB officer became president of Russia.
Now, I know that some legal experts are talking about the fact that a search warrant was obtained for this. This could be a potentially explosive new phase, potentially criminal charges in this. Can you expand upon that, what that search warrant kind of means?
Well, there are a couple warrants that are being discussed. There's certainly in the context of Facebook discussions about whether Bob Mueller is using search warrants to get Facebook to provide information about the Russian interference. In terms of criminal liability, one of the issues that we're looking at, that Bob Mueller is looking at, and he's the ultimate prosecutorial authority, is was there any coordination between the Russians and the Trump campaign? Now, that coordination could have taken the form of giving the Russians information, data analytics, that let them target those ads in a way that would be helpful to the Trump campaign. We want to find out, did that happen? I think it's too early to reach any conclusion. And then there's, of course, the meetings that people have heard about with the president's son and Paul Manafort, Jared Kushner, meeting with the representatives of the Russian government who are offering dirt on Hillary Clinton. So those are very much the subject of our investigation.
And one angle from that meeting that's come up now is the idea that this may have involved money laundering, or money laundering perhaps with campaign manager Paul Manafort may be an issue. Is there anything new on that?
Well, the issue of money laundering is a very significant one, because when people think about what the Russians could have that could compromise the Trump administration or explain why the Trump administration is acting the way it is in terms of wanting to cozy up to Vladimir Putin, they usually think about the salacious video that's mentioned in the dossier. But what would be far more compromising is if the Russians had engaged in illicit financial transactions, money laundering with the Trump organization. That's a crime. The Russians would know about it, the president would know about it, and it's leverage they could use to get the president to act in Russia's behalf and not the behalf of the American people. So that's an issue that needs to be investigated as well. Again, I can't speak to any conclusions, but that's something very important to find out, because we want to make sure that the U.S. policy is serving our interests, not theirs.
Right.
And here in Los Angeles, obviously, DACA is a very big topic. We've heard different stories. Schumer saying we've got a deal. President Trump saying no deal.
Sounds like a game show. Deal or no deal?
Yeah,
what's going on?
Where are we?
Well, here's the thing. You know, the president has certainly made noises recently about wanting to strike a deal on the Dreamers, and we would be all in favor of protecting the Dreamers. But we also recognize this is a guy who in the business world stiffed basically everyone he did business with. And so we go into this with a great deal of skepticism and trust only as far as you can throw him. But if he's willing to do it, this is a guy who acts in his self-interest. We're not going to cut off our nose to spite our face. If we can use this as an opportunity to protect the Dreamers, we're going to do it.
If it includes money for a wall,
that would be a total deal breaker. And the White House and the president, I think, have acknowledged as much and said basically, we'll worry about the wall later. I think the president wants to continue to give lip service to that idea. I think he pretty much has to acknowledge that we're not going to build it and Mexico's never going to pay for it either. But nonetheless, we do have a shot at protecting the Dreamers, and we're going to do our very best.
Real quick on North Korea, it seems like we're really in a box on this. What can be done at this point?
We need to continue to increase the economic stranglehold on North Korea. China's really pivotal in that. All of us need to be pulling together to exert that financial pressure and drive them to the table to first bring about a moratorium on their missile and their nuclear program, and then ultimately roll it back. I don't think we can afford to be acting at cross purposes, so it's not helpful for a president to be calling South Korea appeasers. They're the ones who are most endangered by all of this. But I think the sanctions were a positive step, but we're probably going to need more sanctions, and most important, we're going to need China to really comply with those sanctions.
Yeah,
right.
Definitely.
That's the key, it seems.
All right, Congressman, thank you so much.
Thank you.
Lots to talk about. Yeah, thanks.
Yeah, and he will.